Now we move from those who explore the paranormal to those who have experienced it. We head over to local brewery, the Mitten Brewing, that along with its award-winning beers has a few ghost stories to share. Here's Zach Sgro to tell the tale.
The Grand Rapids Mitten Brewing Company is a building with more to it than meets the eye.
Well, this is engine house number 9, and it was built in 1891 because the downtown fire engine houses couldn't get to fires on the west side fast enough. The building was decommissioned as a firehouse in 1966 and went into private use, and we acquired it in 2012. Right away, we started to see things that weren't right, shadows moving, noises at night.
The unsettling feelings were unfounded either, as the Grand Rapids ghost hunters decided to personally investigate the spooky phenomenon.
I was facing where the kitchen was, and one of the doors were open and the other one was shut. And I saw a man walk past the first window, so I ran upstairs and I'm like, there's somebody in here. I saw somebody in the kitchen.
After operating for nearly a century as a place where men lived and died, the Mitten Brewing Company had little doubt that their suspicions were wrong.
We had a hunch, and one day there was still a man living upstairs when we got it, and we asked him, "Hey man, have you ever seen anything weird or heard anything?" And he nodded his head and he says, "Yeah, there's something here, but just know that it's nothing bad."
The eerie footprint salvaged from the original flooring serves as a marker for the most activity in the upstairs bar.
I've heard multiple people say that they've heard things right around this bar area. We've had knocking things going around the bar, all the way through the back, around here. I've heard running around, no one in the building, but heard people playing around. I've had doors open, I've had lights turn on and off. We've had bar glasses just slide completely off from the bar, and patrons and bartenders all see it at the same time. No explanation, just happens.
Yeah, I think everyone's had their own experience, and I'm sure a lot of them could be probably discounted from a skeptical point of view. But if there is a ghost here, and if ghosts are real, then whatever it is, I believe, is playing pranks on us and appearing one way to someone, appearing in another way to someone else. And maybe there are multiple entities here, an old man, a tiny child, I'm not sure, but all I know is I know this building backwards and forwards. I've been here since the beginning, and I could tell when something's not right. And on more than a few occasions, something that shouldn't be here has made its presence felt.
This has been Zach Sgro for the WKTV Journal.